20 years and counting, World Reading Day is here again, and people are flocking to the National Library of China, the largest library in Asia, to find out the winners of this year's Wenjing Award. The Wenjing Award is now in its 10th year, and has become a major event honoring outstanding works of literature. It is now a flagship event of the National Library of China, and serves its vision to encourage people to read quality books. 10 books were honored this year, covering a wide variety of subjects and genres. Chinese History for Children won for making the rich and complex history of China approachable for young children, while British-born American David Macaulay won for his illustrated book The Way Things Work.
The Wenjing Award was created not just to hand out awards, but to encourage more quality reading in China. And over the past 10 years, we've made a positive impact.
The Wenjing Award is really helpful for bookworms like me because it provides an excellent reference for quality books.
Along with the Wenjing Award, the National Library of China also announced the launch of a new online open learning program. The project offers a vast variety of core subjects, including Chinese characters and culture, as well as about 1,000 lecture videos from the library's archives. Users will be able to access and interact with the National Library system by logging in with their social media account.
What's special about our online courses, compared to many already out there, is that we have the support of an immensely large collection of books in the library, and also a huge database in our digital library. If after listening to a lecture on our online course, you wish to learn more on the subject, then we have the relevant literature recommended to you by experts that are just a click away on the system.
The National Library hopes these initiatives will help improve the current state of reading among Chinese. A recent survey revealed that in 2014, the average Chinese read only 4.6 paperbacks and 3.2 e-books. The figure is about 5 times lower than many Western countries, but reflects a trend seen around the world in the digital age. Many people are too distracted by their mobile phones and the dizzying array of multimedia entertainment available to really delve into a book. Experts worry that these digital devices are shortening the population's attention spans and conditioning the mind to be unable to engage in rigorous thinking. But the National Library of China is battling this trend in trying to draw people back to rediscover the power of books. Stanley Lee, CCTV.